So in this episode, you'll be answering questions on Jessie J.
Yeah, yeah. Who's Jessie J?
Jessica Cornish.
Who's Jessie Cornish?
1988. So no one is looking for sure. J at the end of the Jessie J stage name stands for. She says you can stand wherever you want.
She's not
a compliment to a British-born artist, and she rose to fame in recent years, having written songs for countless artists, including Chris Brown and Rihanna.
I know
the most successful songs which she co-wrote is Miley Cyrus' song Party in the USA, which gained platinum certification in many countries across the globe. So many artists now really want
to she looks like a pole dancer.
Jessie J could do those here. He wants a song about precocious twins and school detention. So Jessie J, if she had to be compared to anyone else in the music scene, she'd like it to be Rihanna, because in her own words, she's one of my style icons. She's a pop star,
okay.
She oozes in it. She's everything I want to be. So Jessie didn't just fly onto the scene though, even before writing songs for her artists, she appeared in adverts and musical productions as a child. She also knew her strengths of songwriting and she discovered
cool.
Herself as a songwriter.
I like the niche.
And she said,
who is that? I don't know who it is. I just don't know who Jessie
like do, which peaked at number 2 on the UK singles charts. She said that she originally wrote the song for Rihanna, but her label liked it so much they wanted her to keep it for herself. So Jessie J revealed that her follow-up single would be titled Price Tag and it featured guest star good friend B.O.B. So upon its release, the single got straight to number 1 on the UK singles charts, the Irish single charts and New Zealand single charts, and in the top 10 in 99 countries across the world. So it remained number 1 in the UK for 2 consecutive weeks, and she released her debut album, which was titled Who You Are, and became
best
one of the biggest selling albums of 2011. So after
that
album sold over 600,000 records,
well, I don't know who it
is. You can see where that is. So it charted at number 2 on the UK albums charts, as well as amazing places around the world.
Don't like that photo.
So, wasn't the only song she wrote, and it was intended to be a favourite artist, but she also wrote a song called L-O-V-E, that I love, which was also intended for Alicia Keys, but then she decided to hold on to it for herself. So Jessie's new single, which is entitled Domino, was released on iTunes in August 2011, now released to radios on 6th of September. Around the same time, she filmed the video for the track. The single currently has only been released in the US, but many people around the world want to release in their territories, especially the UK. So outside of her pop star life, she's less known for having an irregular heartbeat, which unfortunately means she had a mini stroke at the age of only 18. She stays away from smoking and drinking to keep safe after this, and she also stands up against bullying and is recognised as an international role model. Now it's time for questions.
Okay. Jessie J, I don't know who that is. I just don't. So, I don't know who it is. I'm sorry, I just don't.
Yes, because she's talented.
Well, I can't really answer that question. I've only heard one song of hers, but I liked it.
Yes, I quite like her. I enjoy listening to some of her music. Well, the only songs that I've heard from her.
Yeah, I like Jessie J, but, you know, sometimes she can be a bit inappropriate. Why? She's just a good singer and she's a good role model, I think.
I don't know who Jessie J is, so I have no idea what one of her heartbeats are.
What? No.
No, I do not know that.
Jessie J's heartbeats? Are they like her friends or, idols or something?
No, not really, but I'm willing to find out. I could.
I heard Domino is a game. Domino, you know the dominoes. Have you heard Domino? I've heard of the game. I haven't heard if that's a song she's made.
No, I haven't. Yes, because I live in Spain.
I haven't heard Domino, but knowing that her songs are so good, yeah, I guess it should be worldwide.
Yes, I've heard Domino before. I had to do a parody with it, with the team.
Of course it should be released worldwide. It's like the best song ever. It's so good. But I don't think it's fair how she's a British singer, but they can only watch it in America even though she's British, which I think is pretty shocking.
I don't know who it is.
It'd have to be Do It Like a Dude or Price Tag, because they're the only two I've heard.
Well, since I've heard only one song, which name I cannot remember, well, it was nice.
Probably Price Tag. It's quite a catchy tune and yeah.
All of them. But if I had to single out one, it would have to be Who's Laughing Now. The song, it's just amazing, and it's what people can see that will happen.
They both sing?
Rihanna and Jessie J both change their style, and they're both really talented.
They're both girls.
I guess the way she kind of does her album covers or something.
Not much.
Well, I don't know who Jessie J is, so I'm gonna say Rihanna. I've never heard of this person before in my life. I just don't know who it is. I think she's a... Is she like part singer, part hairdresser? Because the first picture is... Maybe, you know. No, you don't know.
I'd have to say Rihanna.
I'd prefer Jessie J.
I think I prefer Jessie J.
Rihanna's just a singer. Jessie J is a role model and a singer, so I'm gonna have to go with Jessie J.
If you want to be in the next Teens Questions, you can send a private message to Teen Talks. Also, subscribe to Teen Talks. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye!